John.
Good.
Turn snap.
Good.
Good. Good. Turn, draw. Good. Get on top of the ball. Yep, good. There you go. Good. And that's what you're capable of doing. But you've been trying to do that without your hips. So if I took you in the weight room and I put you on the curl machine, you could do 35-pound curls. If I got you on a squat rack, you could probably squat 150 pounds 8 times. Okay? That's what you need to understand.
Sure.
And when you're curling, you're just using what? Your arms. When you're doing squats, you're using what?
Your
hips, your diaphragm, the big boy muscles. Okay. And your big boy muscles are nowhere to be found when you're tapped.
Right.
Natalie, the single most important thing is that you get here. Because
okay.
If you drop don't get here, what can't happen?
Drop.
Yeah,
drop.
Which we know is everything.
Right, and she was trying, my coach was trying to tell me the other day, like when I do my approach, I was doing like a windmill.
Yeah, well that's fine. When you started, you had your hand here.
Okay.
Okay, so the next step is this, and we're going to have you do this some more. You've got to break this down. Go on, jump off the box and get on the other side of me there. Okay. All right. Let me show you the position when I jump, I leave the floor. So I haven't even left the ground yet. And I'm already what? Hips open, arm drawn. I haven't even left the floor yet. So the second I leave the floor, I can do what? Turn and tap. You leave the floor like this, so your hips and shoulders are straight, and you don't have your arm already drawn.
Right.
Right. Or when you're drawing from below your waist. So when we leave the floor, I use my arms to help me jump. Watch what happens when my arms get to shoulder height. So if I'm jumping when my arms get to shoulder height, my right arm will draw, my left arm just climbs, and you're kind of wind.
Mm-hmm.
All right, jump back on the box.
Mm-hmm.